a major shakeup in Hawaii's shipping industry. Horizon is out, and its two largest competitors are taking over.
So again, the question, what does it mean for all of us? Just about everything we buy here in the islands arrives via the water, and shipping costs are part of the reason why everything here costs so much money. So we wanted to know what impact this merger might have on prices at the stores.
So first, here's what we know. Matson is taking over Horizon's Alaska operations in a deal worth $456 million.
And Pasha is taking over Horizon's Honolulu to U.S. mainland routes, which is worth about $140 million.
Bridget Namata is digging deeper and talking with an economist who has some concerns. Bridget.
Yes, Howard and Marissa, there is going to be less competition in Hawaii's cargo shipping business. A UH economist I spoke with says it's something to keep a close eye on.
Horizon Lines is described as the only ocean cargo carrier serving Alaska, Hawaii, and Puerto Rico from the mainland. But they're out of the picture now that it sold its Hawaii operation to the Pasha Group, a California-based transportation company. In another part of the sale, Matson, Hawaii's largest ocean cargo carrier, just bought Horizon's Alaska operations.
Matson and Horizon are two big competitors in Hawaii. Clearly, antitrust authorities wouldn't allow a merger of Matson and Horizon in Hawaii, so Matson essentially had to not buy the Horizon Hawaii service. So instead, it was sold to Pasha, which is the third player in the Hawaii market.
Sumner LaCroix studies the current state of economies in the Asia-Pacific region. He is skeptical of this multi-million-dollar merger.
So as a result of the merger, the Hawaii market is essentially reduced from three players to two players. That's always something of some concern when you have a small number of firms.
I asked LaCroix how this would affect the everyday person in Hawaii. Will prices on goods like clothing and food rise?
It's possible the everyday person would see some increase in prices, but mergers also take place because firms expect to see cost savings, and cost savings can also push prices down. So at this point, I think it's really too early to tell.
I talked to a couple of businesses to see whether the change would affect their operations. Costco says it has a pre-existing relationship with the Pasha Group and doesn't see its prices rising right now. Either way, LaCroix plans to follow the latest developments.
The reduction from three firms to two firms is certainly something that antitrust authorities in Hawaii ought to keep a close eye on.
A Matson spokesman says the deal is pending federal regulatory approval. They're expecting it'll go through next year. The Pasha Group tells us it doesn't plan on making any changes to current inner island shipping. Bridget Namata, KH20 News.